Fi-Fi, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a ray of hope.
The love of Jesus Christ, you're an overcomer. Praise God, this is yours truly, Evangelist Willie Grizzle from Scottsville, Kentucky. Amen, praise God. I hope that you're doing fine today, and I hope today that God has put a love in your life that you're willing to listen to others, amen, and help them be an overcomer. Praise God. I'd like to welcome Brother Greg Dotson from Consumer Fire Radio Ministry. Amen, praise God. The one Camp Meeting Radio, amen. He comes on from Monday through Friday at 5 o'clock. Had an awesome service last night. That was awesome. I loved that service. That old brother Urban Taylor up there, he brought the word. Boy, it was a powerful message, amen. Amen. Praise God. You know, if you got an issue, you need to look in the mirror and see if there's an issue with you. Praise God. You know, that was something I took from Brother Urban last night, that if before you start sweeping out somebody else's porch, you need to sweep out your own. Praise God. You know, praise God, that was an awesome message. And today, you know, we're going to be talking about listening. Amen. Praise God. Listen to others. You know, so many people out there today wants to talk and talk and talk, but they don't want to listen. See, they get up on that high horse. They want to do this and do that and the other. But let me tell you something. If you're not listening to the word of God from the men of God, you're lacking. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, like it says over here in Proverbs 1:5. Amen. Write this down. Take wise what the word of God says. It says, a wise man will hear and will increase in learning, and a man of understanding shall attain onto the wise counsel. Praise God. You know, if you hang around a bunch of people that's down and out and boo-hooing all the time, where are you going to learn anything? Amen? Praise God. You see, we got to seek out the men and women of God that are true with Him. And that ain't just a happy one moment and kicking their feet the next moment. Amen? So, brothers and sisters, you got to stay on that plow. Amen? Sister Pauline sings a song all the time. Put your hands upon the plow. Amen. I love that song. You know why? Because when you put your hands upon the plow, you're going to have to drill on through. Amen. See, you can't look to the left. You can't look to the right and hope somebody's going to show up in your ministry or in the chat room or in the church. See, you got to pray them. You got to pray that God will deal with their hearts. But, you know, sometimes you just got to go listen. Amen. Praise God. See what the anointed men and women of God has got to say. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, like I said, Brother Greg Dawson has got a camp meeting radio. Usually it starts at 5 o'clock, Monday through Friday. Hey, won't you tune in? I'll tell you this much. You'll get blessed. Blessed beyond compare, brothers and sisters. So, brothers and sisters, today we're just going to give you an uplifting word. Amen. An uplifting word from the throne room of God. And to tell you that you're not alone in this battle. You know, it seems like a lot of people that I've talked to are under this depression, under guilt, under this. Let me tell you something. You can break the bonds from that today. See, the devil wants to bind you up. He wants to put you in under his feet. See, brother and sister, Jesus said, I come to you to set you free. See, brother and sister, he set you free when he got nailed to that cross. Praise God. And when he got nailed to that cross, he said, I am finished. See, our Lord Jesus Christ came to change your life. Amen. No matter how many people push you around, how many people stomp on you, how many whatever they do, but let me tell you something. If you just grab a hold of that unchanging hand and obey the word of God, see, men and women of God are around you every day. Amen. But you know, the biggest problem, a lot of people want to stick their finger in their ears and sing Kumbaya instead of hearing the word of God. You know why they do that? Because they don't want to be hurt. Because they don't want their sin to be seen. See, brothers and sisters, we got to be truthful with God. We got to stand up and proclaim the word of God wherever we go. Amen. Everybody, you know, it's been going around March 19th. They're going down there in Knott County. They're going to be having a singing, they're going to have fellowship, they're going to have food, they're going to have giving away clothes. Hey, I invite you to come on down there, praise God, and just see what's going on, what God is working out. Amen, praise God. I'm trying my best to find a way to get there. My old truck is pretty well had it, but if it's God's will, I'm going, praise God. But you know, I got to wait for preparedness. Amen. Lord's going to have to show me a way, or financially a way to make it, or somebody come pick me up, or whatever. Either way, I'm going to obey God. Praise God. And I hope today you're obeying God. You know, sometimes when your heart is tore down and you feel like no one cares, let me tell you something. Jesus Christ says he loved you closer, loved you more than a brother. So, brothers and sisters, hold on to Jesus Christ today and just lift up your hands and praise God. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, listen to this song. When my heart is torn to some.
When my heart is torn asunder and my world just falls apart, Lord, you put me back together and lift me up to where you are. There is hope beyond the suffering, joy beyond the tears, peace in every tragedy, love that conquers fear. My body might be dying, but I'll always great and rich reward.
Amen, amen. This mighty might be dead, but let me tell you, I'll live for eternity. Amen, praise God. You know, brother, the ghost, amen, the ghost. Brother Corbin called me a few minutes ago, asked me to keep him in prayer, keep his family in prayer, and Sister Rita, I think, little Petey's mama, I asked her to keep her in prayer. There's some family members that, who was it? Brother Corbin was telling me that a family member, that one of the child has a brain cancer or brain tumor. So right now we're going to pray for that little child. I don't know her name, but God does. Amen. So Lord, Heavenly Father, we come before you, mighty God. We send your healing power upon them, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that whatever this thing about the brain, Lord, we ask you, mighty God, to take it away. Lord, we ask you to shrink it down to nothing. Lord, we ask you, we praise and give you the glory and the mercy and the holy power upon that child. Well, glory, if we would stand in the gap, put all our difference aside, Lord, and we come to one accord, Lord, that we'll see a miracle work in that life, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that you touch them, you give them strength, the knowledge and the understanding, mighty God, that if they have sin upon their life, it to be forgiven, Lord, and to be washed away from them, Lord, by the blood of Jesus, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that you touch them, you heal them, and give them your glory, your understanding, Lord, that the power of the grace of your mighty mercy, Lord, in your holy name, Jesus, we pray for that family and all that's in our hearts and all that's all around Eastern Kentucky and Knott County and all, Lord, that your will be done and only your will, Lord. That it shall come to pass that they be healed. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and king who conquered the grave. Were these the lamb who was slain? Worthy is the king who conquered the grave. Worthy is the lamb who was slain. Worthy is the king who conquered the grave. Worthy is the lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I've seen for all that you've done for me.
Amen, amen, praise God. You know, Jesus Christ laid down his life, amen. He had the power to lay it down. He had the power to pick it back up, brothers and sisters, and you do too. If you're down and out today and you don't know what you're going to do, you don't know how it's going to happen, hey, how about you get on your knees today and let God work in your life, amen, praise God. You need to slow down and listen, like it says in the Old Testament, amen, like the servants of the old, amen, that when it came to the time to hear the word of God, they had to stop, amen, and stood and listened to the word of God. If you look over here in 1 Samuel 3:10, it says this, and the Lord came and stood and said, as to the other time, Samuel, the Samuel answered, spoke, for thou servant heard. See, brothers and sisters, you got to stop and hear what God is telling you today. You got to put your difference behind you. You got to let all this racket that's around you and let it go, because you need to listen to the word of God. You need to take what the men and women of God are telling you today and hold on to it, brothers and sisters, because there's going to be a time that they're going to come and prosecute the men and women of God. They're going to take your Bibles away, brothers and sisters. See, America right now is in danger. We're in danger of slipping away from God. See, brothers and sisters, you can stand up today. And you, every time some evil come knocking on your door or where you work or you walk down the street, you can rebuke that in the name of Jesus. See, brothers and sisters, as a minister of God, we both to raise up our Lord Jesus Christ where he can draw all men nigh to him. Amen. This is like Brother Samuel there. He stopped. He heard what the Lord said. Amen. Now, let me tell you something. If you hear something that's not backed up by the word of God, you better be testing that spirit. Praise God. So many people have caught up in their own self-thinking, their own self-praying, their own self-gratification. But let me tell you something. If you're true with God, you'll hear his voice clearly. Amen. I'd like to introduce everybody in the chat room. We got the Gospel Music Jukebox, Bishop Eddie Cheney. Praise God. We got Sister Carolyn. Amen. We got Sister Pauline, amen. We got Brother Greg, amen. Praise God. Glad to see you in the chat room. I hope today you're being a blessing to someone or somebody's being a blessing to you. Amen, so brothers and sisters. You know, it's a blessing to see all these beautiful faces pop up here. Amen. But you know, so many times that when after the church is done and after all the work is done and everybody goes back to their home, you never hear them about praying for anybody else. Amen. Everybody wants to go in their own little prayer closet and pray for. What about speaking the word of God and speaking life into somebody? To lift to somebody up to a higher plane like where Jesus is. Amen. Praise God. You know, a lot of people have forgot that we're not alone on this earth. You can't think, you think you're just going to hold Jesus and that and that's your ticket to going to heaven. Let me tell you something, brother. If you're not serving God, you're serving the devil. And the devil is going to tear you down. That's right. He's going to tear you down. Now, if you get mad at anything I say, well, take it to God. You don't like it, turn the channel, go clean your house or go fix your car or whatever you got to do. But let me tell you something. The Word of God is coming, and it's coming hard. And let me tell you my understanding of that down there in Knoxville County, Knox County, the Word's going to be stirred right there. Amen. Lord, if I can make it there, woo, boy, we're going to have a good old time in the Lord. There's going to be people that hate me, throw rocks at me. It ain't the first time, praise God. But, you know, I'm going to, if I can make it, amen, Lord's going to have to provide a way. He says, trust in him. I'm going to trust in him, and because he loved me enough to die on the cross, amen. See, we got to put all our bitterness beside of us. We got to, all this saying, gossiping, all this junk that's going all across the telephone lines and internet and all this nonsense needs to come to an end, brothers and sisters. If you want to go to heaven, you better get real with God. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, this is what love is.
That we use loosely, but it holds his power within. And it's what caused a perfect master to lay down his life for man. Oh, and it walks through the fire, and it rises like a flame. It goes deeper than the ocean, and it falls just like the rain. It lasts longer. That's what love is. And it gives, though I'm undeserving, and it washed away my sins. And it fills my heart with gladness, and it makes me whole again. And it walks through the fire, and it rises like a flame. It goes deeper than the ocean, and it falls just like the rain. It lasts longer than forever, and it can't be thrown away. And it was given to us freely in Jesus' name. Love is, that's what love is. I said love is, that's what love is.
Walking into the wolf pack and taking the Word of God, let the Word of God come into people's lives and tell them the truth, amen. You know, a lot of people want to powder the Word of God, but let me tell you something. If you're not listening to the Word of God and you're just sitting there puffed up, well, he's stepping on my toe. Let me tell you something. You need to grow up if you want to go up. And that's the truth, brothers and sisters. So many people today are want to live comfortable in their houses. They want to live comfortable in the church. They don't want to hear the true word of God because they're caught up in their self. Let me tell you something. When you go to heaven, well, God won't care about your opinion. He won't care about what you got in your bank account. He don't care about what all the finer things you got. He wants to know what's in your heart today, brothers and sisters. You know, we worry about people's and multitudes of people when we're around and the how they aggravate us, how they turn us down, how they don't listen. They'll talk to you for a moment, and you try to bring a word to them, and they'll hang up a phone and toss it to the side. Amen. Let me tell you something. One of these days, a phone call is going to be coming from heaven and coming for your name today. Amen. Let me tell you, you can't hang up on God. That's true. Praise God. You can't hang up on God, because God's going to come to your house one day. And he's going to see if you're worthy to be in his kingdom. Amen. Like over here in 2 Chronicles 20:15, and he said, amen. He said, hark ye, all Jerusalem, all and the heirs of Judea, all Judea and all of Jerusalem, and the king of Jehoshaphat, they say the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by the reasons of the great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but of God's. Amen. Praise God. You know, if you're going through a trial today, and if you're torn down today, and you don't know what you're going to do, brothers and sisters, don't take a battle with a fist. You take the battle with the word of God, because God is the one that's going to slay the ones that come against you. The ones that tore you down, the ones that step on you and say this, that, and the other. Let me tell you something. The battle is not yours. It's of God. So, brothers and sisters, you just sit back and praise your hand and worship Almighty God today, because today is the day of salvation. You ain't got time to be worrying about other people's businesses. You got time to be worrying about your own business. Amen. See, with this ministry here is to lift you up, to break the stones in your heart today, that you will stand on the word of God and you will not fall down, you will not faint in the faith, but you'll stand up and proclaim the word of God. You know, too many people have stepped on you. It's time to step back. Step right in the face of the devil and say, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You have no power over me. I serve a mighty God. So, brothers and sisters, if you got somebody in your family, in your life, or a stranger on the street that is putting you down in your ministry, in your life, in your work, you just tell them, I serve a mighty God. And if you don't know this person named Jesus Christ, you will get to know him. You'll meet him one time, amen. You'll meet him the day of judgment. And two things, if you're serving God, he says, welcome in, my faithful servant, or depart from me, you workers of iniquity. That's one time you'll see God, the face of God. Remember that, brothers and sisters. If you're out here putting somebody down and you think, well, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, well, this minister don't know what he's talking about, or that minister don't know what he's talking about, I'm just going to sit here and play Humpty Dumpty with my faith. Let me tell you something, that egg will be broken one day. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, I hope today that you hear what so say the Lord and the word of God telling you today. If you're playing church, let me tell you, game's going to be over one day. That's true. We serve an awesome God. He's a loving God. He's a merciful God. But let me tell you, he's a jealous God and a wrathful God too. So, brothers and sisters, my God's not bipolar. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. Praise God. Did I mention that I'm born again?
That's all right with me. Some folks even hate me, and I don't let it bother me. They call me a rebel, but that's the way I choose to be. Just don't understand.
that inside track to freedom, and I'm living in the light. And did I mention my father is creator, and my brother is a savior, and I hang out with a mighty rushing wind.
Born again today, brothers and sisters. I hope you're in the path of the righteous. I hope that your feet is blessed in the path of the Holy One, the old path. You know, it's a narrow road that we travel, brothers and sisters. We can't pick and choose who we listen to. The men of God are all around you, brothers and sisters. But, you know, there's too much of soothsaying going on. Oh, it'll be all right. You can do that sin. God will forgive. Let me tell you something. No sin will enter into the kingdom of God. Any sin, I don't give a care if you're a child molester. I don't give a care if you're a murderer, if you're just a white lie teller. No sin will enter in the kingdom. You know, so many people today are gossiping across the telephone. So, thank you, Lord. So many people wants to talk about this. Somebody wants to put this mystery down. So put that mystery down. Let me tell you something. If you're going to continue to put some other people down, let me tell you, the wrath of God's going to come upon your door. Amen? That's the fact. So, brothers and sisters, hold on to what God says. Amen? Like it says over here in Psalms 81:8. Hear, O my people, and I will testify unto thee. O Israel, if thou wilt hear unto me. See, brothers and sisters, this is the problem. We got too much distraction up in here in the United States that we hearing of Congress. We're hearing of the people on the street. We're hearing all that. Lord wants to talk to your heart today. He wants you to change away from your sinful ways, your self-thinking, your self-pride. You know, pride is a sin. Amen. That's right. Pride is a sin, and it will keep you out of the kingdom of God. See, we got to humble ourselves down, brothers and sisters. We got to buckle down in the Word of God and listen to what God is telling us today. Too many people is running around saying this, that, and the other. Well, I can't follow them because they're too rough, or they're too much of a soothsayer, or they are too much of sweet preaching. Let me tell you something. If you don't like the way I preach, you don't like the way Brother Eddie preaches, or Brother Irvin preaches, or Brother Greg Dotson preaches, turn us off. You go play your little game in the devil's field. He's got a play box for you. Go ahead. Go right ahead. Let me tell you something. But it comes with a cost, and that's your salvation. That truth is, and it'll stand when the world's on fire. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, we got a testimony from Brother Boyd. So, brothers and sisters, keep your ears out. Let me tell you, this man of God, he'll bring a storm to your life. He'll make you so mad, praise God, that you'll have to come to repentance with Jesus Christ. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, listen to this testimony.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho, and I was going to call in and let you know that we've got an account set up on Facebook over there. It's we've changed it. It's Jesus is Lord of All. It's a account there, and then we can get on there and share the radio programs and stuff. I just shared Battles We Fight, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, through that account on my page and over in our group, Inspire, Encourage, and Preach the Word. And you all are welcome at any time to post over in that Inspire, Encourage, and Preach the Word group. I think there's about 1,700 people in there. I started that group, and Natty Paulpolin is one of the main admins. She runs the God Answers Prayers group, and some huge group. It's like 42,000 people on there, and she's, you know, she's pretty adamant about preaching the Word of God and running those groups and stuff, and she's helping out with my group also. But you're welcome to share any of the programs over there, and when I can get online, I'll share them also. But you may be seeing it posted through Jesus is Lord of All, because when I get on there on my account, I'm in those groups too, and I got a lot of people wanting me to pray for them and stuff, and I get people pretty upset at me if I'm not sitting there, you know, doing their prayers and stuff down there on Facebook. But my dad died on me here, and we've got a couple of disabled people to take care of, my mom to take care of. I got a lot of stuff to do here, and I can't be on there for hours doing prayers and stuff. And I've had people yell at me and curse me out and all kinds of stuff on there for, it's really something, some of the people on there. So some of the times if I can't get on there with my account, I'll be on, we can get on with this other account here, and then can share the radio program so people can still listen to those in the group or on my page too. So anyhow, I just wanted to let you know if you see stuff being shared by that other account there that we're sharing the programs and stuff, and I'm sharing all of Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney's programs over in the group also, and we're getting posted on my page there too so people can hear them. We are called to be watchmen in the book of Ezekiel, and that scripture just really scares me. If we don't warn people about being lukewarm and about sin, then their blood can be accountable on our hands. And it's tough to be a watchman because so many people are living in pornography, homosexuality, and sin. If we preach to them about the sin, they get mad. They're lukewarm. They don't want to pray for people, share testimonies, do the will of God, preach Jesus to the world, help needy people, orphans, widows. They don't want to do anything Jesus says. They just believe a prosperity gospel and believe in Jesus from John 3:16 and think they're going right into heaven. And we have to preach against that. Boy, it sure makes people upset, but I'm glad we're doing the programs. I'm trying to make calls in that could go on CDs or whatever, and hopefully we can, you know, lead people to righteousness and to doing the will of God and help people to truly get born again and get saved. Please turn your heart and life over to Jesus if you haven't. He, like me, can set you free from pornography and so many sins, but you got to be born again, set free of the sins, and please let Jesus help you start doing the will of God, praying for people, sharing testimonies, helping needy people, preaching Jesus to the world. Let's be doers of the word, not hearers only. God bless you all.
I have been such a lonely road, one I thought would never end. No matter where I go, oh, and it's a long ride just to get by. I've learned a lot along the way, and I found my peace of mind, 'cause I've learned how to fight a good fight of faith, a good fight of faith. There's nothing left to bring me down, nothing standing in my way. Just can't take what I know now. Oh, and it's a good ride, I'm more than getting by, 'cause I found a place to make my stay, and it brings me peace of mind.
I've learned how to fight the good fight of faith. I'll never be again. That's one thing that I know. Oh, 'cause it's a hard life just to get by. And I thank God He's made a way to bring me peace of mind. I learned how to fight the good fight of faith. A good fight of faith. There's nothing left to bring me down. Nothing standing in my way. Just can't take what I know. It brings me peace of mind, 'cause I've learned how to fight the good fight of faith. Oh, it brings me peace of mind, 'cause I've learned how to fight the good fight of faith.
Amen, amen. We got to stand the ground, brothers and sisters. The devil is trying to tear down all these small ministries that are growing. You know why he wants to tear them down? Because the truth is going out. The ones that are standing strong for God will take a beating. Let me tell you something. I took a beating and a beating and continue to get a beating, but you know, I'm going to fight that faith. Amen. I'm going to fight for my faith, for the love of God comes in my house, comes in this ministry, and goes out on these airwaves. You know why? Because God has saved my soul. He has blessed my home. He's blessed my family. And let me tell you something. If you love God, you'll be a blessing to someone. Amen. Praise God. You know, I was just looking here in the chat room, and some reason the Lord told me to mention about the outreach program, Saving American Soul, One Soul at a Time. Praise God. Sister Jessie is over that. Praise God. And if you would like to donate something to help the poor, the needy, the ones that need help out there, amen, how about you hit up Sister Jessie Merle there and donate something that somebody else out in this world, in the local Tennessee, Kentucky, they go everywhere. Amen. Praise God. And help them. Amen. Praise God that you would touch the lives of the ones that's been beaten down, the ones that are weak in faith, the ones that needs a touch from God, some mercy. Praise God. You know, a lot of people forget about the mercy of God. He gives us the strength to overcome the battles of the devil. He gives us the power to overcome the temptation. He gives us to be an overcomer, brothers and sisters. You got to be an overcomer in the Word of God, because only His Word that can be applied to your heart that you can live by. Amen. Now, you can follow all the rules of the world and be happy. But let me tell you something. If you want to be blessed, you better obey God. Not just be a hearer, but a doer, brothers and sisters. Because God is coming back, and He's looking for somebody that's faithful and worthy to be in His kingdom. Praise God. You know, like it says over here in Malachi 1:2, it says, "Hear all ye people, hearken all, O earth, that and that all therein is, let the Lord God be a witness against you, the Lord from the holy temple. See, God's going to be a witness to what you've done, what you're doing, and how you're doing it. Amen? You know, I tell my wife all the time, when people come up there and they yell and scream and talk about me and all that good stuff, and I said, honey, why? This is what I do. The five W's. You know, I don't know if you remember when you was in school. When you done a project, amen, you done the five W's. What, where, when, why, and who. See, you got to see where they're coming from, brother, sister. What have they done to be in this situation? Amen. And what can be done to cure up that situation? Only way to be cured up is the word of God. You see, you got to obey God to the fullest. It ain't just what your preacher tells you, or what your bishop tells you, or your evangelist tells you. You got to get in the word and study the word and apply it to your heart, brothers and sisters. You can't just say, play around pitter-patter with God's word, because he ain't playing no games. Amen? That's the biggest problem with people in the church today, especially these highfalutin churches, that you got to have a program. You can only sing three songs, or the only time you can pray is when the preacher calls you up to pray. Well, let me tell you something. If you need to pray and the preacher is preaching and you need a prayer, you walk up to that man of God and says, I need a prayer right now. Oh, you can't. You got to. No, I want it right now. God told me to come here. I'm coming. And we'll see if he is a true man or woman of God. Amen. Praise God. That's how we got to do. We got to be bold in the word of God. When God tells you to do something, get up and go. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, listen to this song very closely. God don't slip around. Praise God.
If God took a little walk up to your house and slipped on down to mine, would he find us busy with the things of the world, or be happy with what he did find? If he tiptoed up our front doorstep and entered without a sound, would he find what he had found? Oh, but God's not slipping around, and he's not tiptoeing in. He's here all the time. He's yours and he's mine. He's watching and waiting, my friend. Well, I knew that he saw everyone else and never looked in on me. Oh, but brother, how I got a fooling, and sister, how I got a slack. He not only knew where my house was, he had a complete roadmap. Yeah, 'cause God's not slipping around, and he's not tiptoeing in. He's here all the time. He's yours and he's mine. He's watching and waiting, my friend. We'll be right back. step out of the saddle. Our position is always on call. Yeah, 'cause God's not slipping around, and He's not tiptoeing in. Yeah, He's here all the time. He's yours and He's mine. He's watching and waiting, my friend. Well, He's here all the time. He's yours and He's mine. He's watching and waiting, my friend.
Hey, man, hey, man. See, God don't sneak around. He knows what, He's got His eyeball on you every second of every moment. Doesn't matter if you're out here feeding the hunger or giving the clothes. He knows your heart when you're out by yourself and how you treat other people, how you treat your family, how you treat your brothers and sisters that are down and out. Say, hey, amen. You know, Brother Boy put something in the chat room here. You write this down. I want everybody to study that. Luke 16, 19 through 31. It's talking about Lazarus and the king. Amen. The king had the great things of life. He had the finer things of life. Lazarus, he was sitting at the gate. Amen. He just wanted crumbs from the table of the king. He sat there and the dogs licked his wounds and all that. And Lazarus died. Amen. And then the king died. Well, Lazarus went to the bosom of Abraham. Amen. Praise God. But the king, he went to hell. He went to hell and torture. And he wanted Abraham to dip his finger down in cool water to cool his tongue because he was in torment. See, brothers and sisters, you can't pray your way out of hell. You know, that makes me so sick. I see people on Facebook and YouTube, they says, oh, I want to pray my dad out of hell. Let me tell you something. He made a choice while he was on this earth. He did not serve him. So he pays for the consequences. It's harsh, brother, but it's the truth. The truth will stand when the world is on fire, brothers and sisters. You don't believe me? You keep running your race of your make-believe faith. There's only one true faith, and that's the faith of Jesus Christ. Praise God. If you don't like it, turn the channel, turn the page. Amen. Praise God. But this house of prayer here, the radio ministry, is going to bring you the truth. You don't like it? Well, plug your ears. Go away. Amen. But the truth will stand. Amen. So, brother and sister, let's listen to another testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd Glendon in Idaho. I was going to leave my prayer for us also here, and I just wanted to ask for prayers for all of us here also. You know, we can use prayers here. My dad, Boyd Glendon, you know, was doing great and on staff working with the teaching the preschool kids at our church all week long how to read and write about Jesus along with my mom, and then had a bad stroke and battled with infections for 3 months and passed away on us. And, you know, that's been tough for us here. And he left us. We got a couple disabled people. My grandma, Naomi, who's 95, to take care of him. My sister, Ann, who has schizophrenia. She's had that since she was a kid. She weighs 540 pounds. She's on level 5 oxygen and breathing machines. Has to have medication all the time, food brought into her, all kinds of stuff here. And my mom's older now. Got to take care of her. And so my dad left me with a lot of people to take care of here, so I've been real busy between trying to take care of the disabled people and everything that's got to be done around here and trying to do some ministry stuff also. So please pray for Jesus to give me strength here and heal and help my family out. My grandma's getting stronger, even though she almost died a few times. My grandma Naomi, the prayers have helped her, and my sister Ann's doing a little bit better too. The prayers are helping her, and I just thank God and Jesus for helping us all. But I haven't been able to be online a lot and over on Facebook. Sometimes I have people mad at me, yelling at me on there because I haven't been on there doing the prayers and stuff, but I've been real busy here with everything that's going on. So I try to get on there when I can, and I call in calls all the time to this line and to the other radio line. I've been calling a lot of calls to that other radio line also to help get the good news of Jesus out to a lost, dying, and hurting world. So even if I can't be online working ministry stuff, I'll be making calls into these programs, and I'll be on there praying for people when I can over on that Facebook. And Father, right now I want to come to you in prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for Jesus dying on the cross for our sins and for our sicknesses and diseases, for our trials and challenges. Thank you, Father, that you are love and you love us. You loved us so much that you gave your one and only Son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. So our sins can be forgiven, so we can be healed from our sicknesses and diseases, and rescued from our sins, and set free from our sins, and delivered from our trials and challenges.
Right now, I want to pray for anyone hearing this who struggle with sin, for you to set them free from their sins. We claim they are set free. They will know the truth, and the truth will set them free. We claim it right now. They are getting set free from sins. I want to pray for Brother Willie, for his wife and daughter, for my family here, for anyone needing healing. We claim our healing by the stripes, wounds, in the name of your son, Jesus Christ. Right now, we claim our healing. Jesus, our groanings, and bore our sicknesses. Now, 17, you forgive all our sins. You all over Jesus. Redeem our lives from destruction. Psalm 103, we claim our healing right now. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father, for getting the strength to go through our lives. Philippians 4:13 says we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Give us strength to make it through our trials and challenges. Thank you, Father, for strengthening us and healing us and helping us all. And I pray this prayer in the name of your son, Jesus. Amen. God bless all.
Make a way for. Make a way for the King is coming.
Make a way for.
our King is coming, my friend. And if you're not ready and you're living your life in sin, if you're a liar, if you're a whoremonger, if you're a thief, if you're stealing from God and not doing what God tells you to do, and you're just sitting and playing the pity-patty game, let me tell you something. You're going to be like that King. Amen. You're going to be sitting on that hot rock in hell, begging God to get you from that place. But it'll be too late, my friend, because you will be burning in hell for eternity. And that's the choice you make today. Do you want to serve a living God? Do you want to be God to give you the boldness to stand up and proclaim the word of God? Or are you just going to sit around and play pity-patter? Amen. This is like it says in Acts 2:14. This is what Peter said. But Peter stood up with the 11. Now, did you get what happened here? Peter stood up with the 11. The disciples together, they had one voice, one speaking out to the people, all the people. Amen. Praise God. And he says, lift up your voice and stand up unto them. Ye men of Judea and all you that dwell in Jerusalem, be this known unto you. Hearken unto my word. The word of God, brothers and sisters. You got to get loud. You got to stand up and proclaim the word of God. Too much of this soft speaking junk is going on, brothers and sisters. Our Lord is coming closely and closer every day. You need to break the bonds of sin of you upon your life. The bonds of depression, the bonds of self-doubt, fainting in the heart. You got to break them bonds with the word of God. I speak life into you, brothers and sisters. I speak there is a better way to live. There is a better place that you can go. There's a place that you can touch God today. You don't have to sit and whine and complain. You just got to get up and obey the word of God. You don't have to lie to yourself. Because when you lie to yourself, if God is in you, you're lying to God too. That's right. You don't like it, you take it with God. It's the truth. If you're not doing the Father's will, you're not rebuking sin, you're not casting out demons among all these people with the word of God, you're lying to yourself. And that's a fact. Because God gives us the power. He gives us authority of heaven over earth. Amen. If God dwells within your heart today, brothers and sisters, it's time to light your fire. It's time for you to get up and speak loud like Peter and these 11 disciples. Amen. You know, too many times we sit quiet. We stood there, well, they don't give me an opportunity to preach, or they don't give me an opportunity to give my testimony. Well, brothers and sisters, if you're looking for an opportunity, I got one for you. Amen. 270-681-8098. Brother Boyd calls it. That's the only one's been calling lately. You know, I know a lot of men and women of God, but they won't pick up a phone and give a 3-minute testimony. It's true. Like, they claim to be something. They claim to be a bishop. They claim to be an evangelist. They claim to be a teacher. They claim to be a man of God. But when I give them a number, oh, well, that costs us money. Well, let me tell you something. I'd rather spend, let's say, 50 cents on a call and bless somebody else's heart. You know what I mean? Come on. Now think about this. You know, a lot of people won't have no fellowship with me because they're tied up in their own self-thinking. Amen? They're tied up in their own thinking. They won't, they won't come to my ministry and they won't do nothing for me. I ain't going to do nothing for them. Well, you want to live your life in self-pity, you go right ahead. That's true. I ain't going to lie to you. There's too many of this. Well, this guy's picking on me, or that guy's picking on me, or this preacher's picking on me. Oh, let me tell you something. If it hits you, you need to deal with it. Amen? See, we have a short period of time on this earth, brothers and sisters, and then we're going to leave. Then we face judgment. You know, a lot of people don't fully understand that scripture. Away from the body to be with the Lord. Then, what? Face judgment. Praise God. You know, a lot of people talk about, well, when you die, you go to sleep. Yeah, but your soul goes to judgment. Think about this. A lot of people don't really realize that. The body goes back to the earth where it belongs. But your soul goes to the kingdom of God. See, think about this. See, everybody thinks, well, if you go to face judgment, all right, praise God, thank you, Lord, that when you go to judgment, that your health there, good or bad, it doesn't matter, and that you're in heaven. Whoa, let's get something clear here. The Word of God says this: did you go face judgment for your deeds? Now, if you go fight for your deeds, He ain't going to keep sin in His kingdom. You know, the Lord was sharing that with me this morning, and it hit me like a ton of bricks. Think about that. If you are in sin, God ain't going to keep filth in His house. You know what I'm saying to you today, brothers and sisters? Because if you have an ought against thy brother, if you have a secret sin, if you're a homosexual and you're hiding it, let me tell you something. It will be revealed to God. And you will not enter into the kingdom of God. If you're a drunk, you go to church and whenever the door is open and you're drinking beer and you get just sloppy drunk, you don't think God don't see that? You don't think He ain't got your number? You don't think He ain't got your book? Think about this, brothers and sisters. You can't hide from God. You know, there it talks about, if I ain't mistaken, back in Revelation, it said there will be a day when people will run into the mountains and cry for the rocks to fall to hide themselves from the face of God. Think about this, my friend. If you're lost and undone today, I want you to understand where you stand with God. You can't hide from God. You can't go stepping around and say, well, I'll do this and I'll fool everybody. Let me tell you, you ain't gonna fool God. You might fool me. You might fool all these men of God. But you ain't gonna fool the great I am, our Lord Jehovah God. Amen? So, my friend, take a hold what so say the Lord today, that God will bring you back to the fold.
Lord, I know how long you waited for me to come back home, 'cause I know how long I was gone. But Lord, I never knew until I lost sight of you just how lonely I could be on my own. Now I'm back in the fold, back in the fold, knowing, sweet Jesus, that you're in control. No longer apart, at last I am home. Lord, it feels so good to be back in the fold. There's nothing sadder in all creation than a soul in isolation, away from the sound of God's voice. But there'll be no time for tears. Lord, I've paid for my lost years. All I want now is to sing and rejoice. 'Cause I'm back in the fold, I'm back in. That you're in control, no longer apart, at last I am home. Lord, it feels so good to be back in. That you
you're in control. The longer apart, at last I am home.
Lord, it feels good to be back in.
Amen. You know, our job as a watchman, amen, praise God, is like what Brother Boyd says in the chat room here, Ezekiel, the task of a watchman. You write that down and you take and open your Bibles and see what that says. It says 16 through 19, amen, praise God. It talks about that if you don't warn people about their sins, they will die and burn eternity in hell. Turn away from your evil ways. And grasp, behold, the Lord Jesus Christ in his holy name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, check it out. Ezekiel 3, 16 through 19. And apply that to your heart. And because if you apply the word of God to your heart, you can't do evil. And if you're born again, you can't sin anyways. But if you do, that means you're falling away from God. That's true, brothers and sisters. You can get mad. You can pick rocks, throw it at me. It's happened to disciples. Hey, think about this. There's been disciples that's been bold. They've been nailed to the cross. They've been hit with rocks. I mean, it ain't easy being a Christian. But let me tell you, the payday is coming. That white gown, amen, and that crown. One day when we leave this earth and we've done our deeds, amen, that we have put our hand off on that gospel plow, and we have plowed all the way to the glory land, that we will truly be free. Right now, we're trapped in this sinful world. But we both be watchmen. We both to be telling the world today that God is coming back. We don't know the hour or the day, but God is coming. Are you willing to put your hands upon that plow today, brothers and sisters? Are you ready for the coming of Jesus Christ? And that's the truth, brothers and sisters. Too many of our brothers and sisters are laying to the side. They're wounded. They're hurt. And they've been battered. But you know, if you look at all the disciples, they just didn't lay down. Amen. Think about this, brothers and sisters. We're not here to fight among each other. We both together, ourselves together, where God can draw us nigh to him. Well, we could be on a different playing field, a different anointing, a different understanding of the Word of God. So many people hear, but they're not being a doer. They not got up and give their life to the Lord. They have copied what other people's done. They have repeated after the preacher, but they have not truly fully submitted themselves to God. See, brothers and sisters, so many of my friends and family has been a copycat. I mean, they want to say, well, I'm going to imitate what this guy on TV is doing. Or I'm going to go see what this other guy is doing. I mean, I'm going to learn from him. But let me say, tell you something. The Holy Ghost will teach you everything you need to know. Now, God, don't get me wrong. God, men and women of God will come and sometimes they'll bring an encouraging word. Sometimes they'll bring a staff. I know. I've been whipped by it. Amen. But today I want you to understand that God loves you. But he don't love your sin. Amen. And it's your choice today if you want to be separated from your sin. You got to be fully submitted, brothers and sisters. You can't just sit here and whine and complain about the situations of life. Do something about it. Stand up. Amen.
My heavenly home is bright and fair. I feel like trying to be born more. Lord, thank no death. He too there. I feel like trying to be born more. Thank you.
Praise God. Praise God. That I feel like traveling home. You know, I want to go to be with the Lord. But you know why I'm down here? I want to get people encouraged to show the mercy of God. I want people today to know that Jesus Christ is still alive and still doing the miracle work in businesses. You can get a piece of that, brothers and sisters, if you'll just fully submit yourself. Don't care about what people say about you or how they put you down. Let me tell you something. The ones that do this is going to be judged double. Think about this. Praise God. You know, a lot of people think, well, if I just come with a harsh word or I just beat them to death, and if they don't do what I tell them to do, they're going to hell. Well, let me tell you something. Praise God. There's only one great judgment that you'll ever have to worry about, and that's our Lord's. Amen. But you know, you better have a good attorney. Amen. And that's Jesus Christ. Is he going to walk into your life on the day of judgment? Is he going to be there? Or are you going to stand before a mighty God and answer for your deeds on your own accord? Praise God. This is why we need to come to the Word of God. You know, like it says over here in Acts 28:28, be it known therefore unto you, the salvation of God is sent unto the Gentiles, and they that will hear it. Amen. See, you got to hear the salvation come into your life, brothers and sisters. The one is the true Word of God. The one that needs to stand up and proclaim the Word of God. Quit playing the dilly-dally game and put your salvation to work. You can't just be a hearer. You got to be a doer. You got to get on that battlefield. If they spit on you, they cuss you, they call you all kinds of weird names, let them do it. See, we don't fight a battle. God does. All we do is plow on. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, this song is for people that's in that trouble right now. That's at trouble waters. And you're hurting. You're cussing me out. Why am I listening to this? I'll tell you why. Because God decided you to be here today to hear this word. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, listen to this song about troubled waters.
Troublesome water around me now rolls, rocking my boat. And sinking in sin. Troublesome waters are pulling them in. Then gently I feel the touch of God's hand, guiding my boat to a better land. It's leading to heaven's bright shore. Troublesome waters, I'm fearing no more. Out on the high sea, there's an awful sea monster troubling my soul. While under the water, there's an unseen hand guiding my boat to that better land. Since waves are dashing and rolling so high, above this loud noise, you can hear my sad cry. Lord, I'm trusting, have mercy on me, and steady my lifeboat while I'm out at sea. Then
gently I feel the touch of God's hand. Guiding my boat to a better land. It's leading the way to heaven's bright shore. Troublesome waters I'm fearing no more. Troublesome waters I'm fearing no more.
Praise God. You know, brothers and sisters, you don't have to be in them troubled waters. God's reaching down his hand for you right now. Right where you're sitting. Right, if you're listening to the internet or on the radio, on the satellite radio, stop and think about today. Are you in troubled waters? That you're stuck in your faith? You don't know what to do? First thing, you need to pray. You need to see where God wants you to go. What he has you to do. And who to help. Amen. See, brother, sister, we're only on this earth for a short period of time. Then we leave. My friend, take a hold of what God's word says to you today. You know, like it says over here in Matthew 17:5. Amen. You know, when Jesus got baptized by John the Baptist, praise God. And it says this. Well, he yet spoke, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them. And behold, a voice from the clouds, which said, this is my beloved son, in him I am well pleased. Hear ye him. Amen. See, if you want to please God, you got to have that bright cloud in your life. You got to look positive. You got to feel positive. And you got to bring positive word to the people of God. Even the ones that's lost out there, the sinner, the ones that backslidden, the old generals that used to be on the battlefield. Wake them up. Get them out of the mud. Pick them up. Give them an encouraging word. Give them the strength of God. See, every time you turn away from somebody, that's another soul that's closer to hell. That's right. Doesn't matter how mad they make you or what they've done to you or your ministry. See, we're not here to serve our own ministries. We're here to serve the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. Today, you can be a minister in the Word of God if you'll just take a hand of Jesus Christ. Amen. Do you remember when Peter stepped out of that boat and Jesus told him to come on? Well, he was doing fine. All right? Till he seen a storm around him. He took his eyes off of God, and he started to sink. See, brothers and sisters, you can't take your eye off of God. You can't take your eye off of Jesus. Because the moment you take your eye off of Jesus, you will sink and you will drown. So, brothers and sisters, today, if you want to please God, reach for his hand. Touch him. Feel him. Let that Holy Ghost come around you, brothers and sisters. Have him inside and out. Have double coverage, brothers and sisters, because the devil is at his game, and he does it well. So, brothers and sisters, you have the power to step on that devil and kick him back where he belongs, back into the hell, that hot rock where God sent him the first time. Brothers and sisters, we need to stand up and tell the world, I belong to Jesus. I don't belong to man. I don't belong to a building. I don't belong to the neighbor dog. I belong to Jesus. That's the only name, brothers and sisters, that'll get you into heaven. To live eternity with him. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, I just want to tell you, we need to be looking for that eastern star. Eastern sky, because one day he's coming back. He's coming back for ones that are ready for Jesus. But if he catches you with mud on your outfit, amen, and you're hiding some kind of sin, let me tell you something. You won't go where he is. Amen. So, brother and sister, enjoy the song. Look on to that eastern sky.
Ooh.
teacher of truth, told tales of troubled times that would begin. And the cynical sowers sowed the sorrowful seeds of seven sins. The people placed a price upon the Prince of Perfect Peace, and the one who wooed the world was wounded. Look unto thee. The morning moved in mournfully, with many moments marred by brawny beasts who beat the beauty, bowed and bent and barred. Laid the lash upon him low, his lips moved not the least. See him come from where he did go now. Look unto me. The devil drew his darts, and the dearest dove came dropping down. But the spirit slips in soft and sweetly, unseen with no sound. The comforter, the counselor, with us till time is ceased. And the groom will return for his bride. Look unto me. And the groom will return for his bride. Look unto thee.
Praise God. So brothers and sisters, today if you are in trouble and you're covered in sin, you can be washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. You know who you are. You know you've done wrong, and you know that you've come against your family, friends, and all you got to do is repent. Turn away from your wicked ways and grab a hold of Jesus Christ's hand and let him love you, give you mercy, and forgive you of all your sins. You know, like John 10:27 says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. What are you hearing today, brothers and sisters? Is God tugging your heart that you need to, you know that you need to get right? Do you need Jesus today? I need him every day. You know, I walk through this walk of life, and there's things that come in my life that I have to just pray to God to forgive me for. You know, I'm not perfect, but what dwells within me is. And he's trying to get out. He tries to get out more and more every day. But the question is for you today. Do you have a vacant spot for Jesus today? Amen. He wants to come have supper with you. He wants you to stand up, get loud, and get live. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, don't let the foolish things of this world tie you down. Don't let theology turn you away. Just come to the Word of God. Get grounded in it. And proclaim the Word of God. I'm not here to bash you, but if I said today that's hurt your feelings, you need to talk to God about it. See, the Holy Ghost has been on me all morning. And this is what he's told me. My people dying of lack of knowledge. They're not listening to me. They're listening to all this other nonsense of the world. My friend, if you're lost out there and you got an ought against thou brother, if it's me, if it's Brother Eddie, if it's Brother Greg, or it's Brother Chris, you better get it clear. You better straighten it up, because you come against God's anointed ones, you will pay the wrath of God, and that's without a doubt. See, brothers and sisters, We're only on this earth for a short period of time, and then we're gone. I know it looks rough, it looks hard, and it's been a rough message today. But let me tell you something. It breaks my heart to see so many people walk away from God. They're caught up in making money, caught up in making a name for themselves. Only name I want above my door is Jesus. Amen. Yeah, this is the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. Yes, I am Evangelist Willie Grizzle from Scottsville, Kentucky. But I don't want you to see Willie. I want you to see Jesus. I want you to see what God has done for me, where he can do it for you too. I want you to stand up, proclaim the word of God as like all the disciples of the old and the disciples of the new and the disciples that's around you today. Look at them. Look at the fruits. If they blessed you, why don't you bless them? If you've been fed from this ministry today, I'm not asking for your money. I'm not asking for a pat on the back. What I want you to do is, first thing, is praise God. Second thing, I want you to, if you don't mind, just push the like button up on speaker, right under the player. And the third thing is to share the services. You know, there's another anointment coming upon me. And God is strengthening me, giving me the power of his glory to speak the word as I ought. And like, again, March 19th down there in Knott County. I ain't got the address, but I'm working on it. Amen. And I'm trying my best to be able to go down there. Praise God. So, brother and sister, pray for me and my finances and my vehicles. Amen. My old truck's about had it. It's got all close to 300,000 miles on it. I've been all over Kentucky, Tennessee, Alabama. I've been everywhere. And the old truck's about to lay down on me. But I know God's going to take care of it. He always does. I have no doubt in that. So, brothers and sisters, please continue to pray for me, pray for my family, and pray for these men and women of God that are still on the battlefield fighting for souls like yours, that you need to stand up and proclaim the word of God. Don't sit around pouting and boo-hooing about things and situations you have no control over, but just stand up and proclaim the word of God. Because one day soon, we will face a mighty God. Praise God. And I want to see everyone up there, brothers and sisters. I want to see your glorious faces upon the world today, to showing that Jesus Christ is still alive and still in a miracle-saving business. He is in a healing business. He is the great I Am, and there is no other. This is yours truly, the Evangelist Willie Grizzle from Scottsville, Kentucky. I hope that the Lord has blessed you, sanctified you, and washed you in his blood. I hope that something the Lord had me to share with you today has touched your heart to think about where you stand with God. But most of all, continue to pray that God will use you in a mighty way, that you'll stand up and proclaim the word of God wherever you go. Whatever situation comes upon your life, that you will be a soldier for the Lord, that you won't take a beating from man, but you'll stand up and face the devil face to face, because we all do, brothers, sisters. Put the suit on and get ready for war, because it's coming, my friend. So, brothers and sisters, I hope that you are ready to wear your robe of white, because I sure am. I'm ready to leave. I'm ready to fly on out of here. Amen. So remember me in prayer. Remember the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. But most of all, remember yourself in prayer. God bless you all.
My Bible tells me.
My Bible tells me.
My my Lord has gone.
My Lord has gone.
For me to prepare.
For me to prepare.
A mansion grand.
A mansion grand.
And after a while.
And after a while.
Oh, yes, I know.
Oh, yes, I know.
I'll wear a white robe.
I'll wear a white robe. In the glory land.
And sing with the angel.
And sing with the angel band. Bright angel band. Just inside the gate. Where loved ones await.
I'll wear a white robe.
I'll wear a white robe. In the glory land.
I'm only a pilgrim.
I'm only a pilgrim
here below.
Down here below.
While journeying through.
While journeying through.
The desert sand.
The desert sand.
And after a while.
And after a while.
Oh, yes, I know.
Oh, yes, I know.
I'll wear a white robe.
I'll wear a white robe. In the glory land.
And sing with the angel.
And sing with the angel band. Bright angel band. Just inside the gate. Where loved ones away.
I'll wear a white robe.
I'll wear a white robe. In the glory.